Nadir Naim. He's the former deputy chairman of the High Peace Council. Thanks so much for joining us here on the News Hour. We've had a very eventful days in Afghanistan over the past few days. We've seen simultaneous presidential inaugurations. Tell us, and negotiations, of course, are still underway to resolve this. How will this be resolved? How does it play out?
Thank you very much for having me. Indeed, it's been a roller coaster of a week here in Afghanistan. And yesterday, we witnessed something for the first time in the history of Afghanistan, having two inauguration ceremonies. We were very much hoping to avoid that. And there was a shuttle diplomacy, especially on the part of Zalmay Khalilzad, the special envoy of the U.S. in Afghanistan. Unfortunately, they could not come with a deal or a settlement. So the two inauguration went on in parallel spaces. And now we really need to sort this out. And I think there is hope, given the fact that in both inauguration speeches, both President Ghani and Dr. Abdullah stated that they are willing and they showed basically flexibility to come up with some kind of an agreement. And this is something that's really required at this crucial juncture in our history, because basically we're facing with a very important negotiations or with the Afghan government and the Taliban.
Indeed, and it is such a crucial juncture, as you say, and some people say that this this rivalry in politics right now actually plays into the hands of the Taliban. Would you agree?
Unfortunately, this is very much the case, because the Taliban have always questioned the legitimacy of the Afghan government, and especially with this scenario building up, it's even more questionable now, the legitimacy of the Afghan government. So yes, this has definitely played by de facto to their favor, unfortunately.
And let's talk about a possible prisoner release of handover of Taliban prisoners. Previously, President Ghani said that this was a red line that he would not cross, but now he may release 1,000 prisoners this week. What would be the consequences and impact of this with regards to negotiations with the Taliban?
Well, if I can just go back and just give you a kind of a brief rundown of how this came to be. Initially, with Zalmay Khalilzad, the special representative of the U.S. came for the peace negotiations with the Taliban from the U.S. He had four specific targets, out of which, in during the 18 month of negotiations, he managed to get two targets in the agreements between Taliban, and that was basically the future threat of the U.S. from the Afghan soil in the Taliban controlled territory, and also the Taliban's request for a total foreign and U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan. And now, point or target three and four were, one was basically to have a ceasefire, a nationwide ceasefire, and then the Afghan negotiations. At the end of this agreement, the Taliban came up with two more conditions for starting the negotiations. One was that they said, and they were adamant, that first they would sign the agreement with the U.S. for the total withdrawal of the U.S. forces, and secondly, the release of the 5,000 prisoners. So I'm pretty sure that this was talked back to the Afghan president, Ashraf Ghani, by the special representative of the U.S., Zalmay Khalilzad. And this case was put forward. I'm pretty sure that even months ago, the list of the prisoners were given to President Ghani. And I also would assume that President Ghani, to some extent, agreed upon this. But I think at the last minute, when the tonality of the Taliban representatives in Qatar put it in such way that, you know, the U.S. has promised us the release of 5,000 prisoners, almost sidelining the president. And I think the president's reaction was due to that. What's really interesting is that last night, Ismail Khan, who's a jihadi leader, had an interview in one of our local TV stations, and basically what he had said was that the night before the inauguration, the Americans and President Ghani had a chat, and in that chat there was an agreement made whereby the U.S. and Zalman Khalilzad and the U.S. representative will come and be part of the inauguration, and in return, the president would agree in signing the release of the prisoners. From what we understand at this first initial stage, 1,000 prisoners are going to be released by a special decree from the president. So this is not something that's just sprung up. This is something that's been going on for a while, and I think the president knows very well that the Taliban require for the 5,000 prisoners to be released before the Afghan negotiation starts.
Thank you so much for explaining the background to that prisoner release. Another strand, big news coming out from Afghanistan is that the US has reportedly begun withdrawing its troops from the country. How would this impact security in Afghanistan?
Well, this is something very crucial. I think, you know, now the starting gun has been fired and the timetable has been set. And the U.S. is adamant to get on with it and basically withdraw the two as per the agreement signed with the Taliban. This is a wake-up call for everyone. Everyone was, I think, for most part, in denial that the U.S. will not withdraw. But, of course, one day this day would come, and this is the time where we need to have some kind of peace settlement, stabilization in the country while the U.S. is still present, while the foreign troops are still here, and we need to have a stable and peaceful Afghanistan before that time runs out.
And I just want to read a quote to you from Mike Pompeo, Secretary of State. He said, prioritizing an inclusive government and unified Afghanistan is paramount to the future of the country and particularly for the cause of peace. Do you see an Afghanistan speaking with one voice very soon?
I wouldn't want to put a time frame on it, but I think now the pressure is on. And Mike Pompeo also said that, you know, a parallel government is unacceptable. So these are all pressure points that would lead. And I think, you know, the agreement itself is also a pressure point for all the Afghan politicians to come together and build a platform for peace and negotiations and of course, the teams to go and negotiate with the Taliban. This is paramount and it's essential.
And as you said, it's such a critical juncture. So much has happened this week. How, you know, are ordinary people going about their lives and seeing these big developments in their country?
Well, to be quite honest with you, I really feel for the nation because basically this is the first chance that they see after 40 years that there's a real chance for peace. And I think, you know, what's happening in the kind of political arena is very disappointing for them, especially the two inaugurations. I think it's kind of put fear into people's mind that, you know, are we going to waste the one given opportunity for peace after 40 years? So they're very concerned. And I think, you know, for the sake of the nation, our politicians and our leaders should come together and really make a go out of coming up with a unified platform for the peace and future settlement of Afghanistan.
Indeed. Nadir Naim, it's been a pleasure to have you on the News Hour here on TRT World. Hope to speak to you again soon. Thank you.